गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन. माई सेल्फ सूरज कुमार सोनी एंड दिस इज़ द पार्ट नंबर 4 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2 सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्लास 12 साइंस केमिस्ट्री. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी स्टडीड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, टाइप ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस एंड सम कंसंट्रेशन टर्म्स बाय विच वी कैन डिटरमाइन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूशन लाइक मोलैरिटी, मोलैलिटी, मास परसेंटेज, वॉल्यूम परसेंटेज, मोल फ्रैक्शन and some other terms we have studied in the previous video. And we studied like solubility of gas, solubility of solid in liquid, Raoult law, and elevation in Raoult law, positive deviation, negative deviation in the Raoult law, from the Raoult law, and so many terms, and the Henry law we studied in the previous video. If you don't see the video, just see the previous video for the better understanding of this video. Because in this video we study about some of the colligative properties depending upon the particles, number of particles present in the solution. Okay, now we start. First see the index, which topics we will study in this video. We will study topic first is four concentration terms. First one is relative lowering of vapor pressure, second is elevation of boiling point, third is depression of freezing point, and fourth is osmotic pressure and osmosis. And then we will studied calculation of the molar mass from the osmotic pressure, then classification of solution on the basis of the osmotic pressure, then we will studied reverse osmosis. These are the four terms we will study in this video, and then some use of the reverse osmosis in the water purification. What are the applications of the reverse osmosis in the water purification? These terms we will studied in this video. Now we start. The first colligative property is relative lowering of vapor pressure. How the vapor pressure increase or decrease in this video we will study. Vapor pressure of a solvent present in a solution is less than the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. The meaning is that if the any solution contain the non-volatile solute, then vapor pressure decreases. If any solution contain volatile solute, then vapor pressure increases. According to Raoult law, lowering of vapor pressure of a solution depend only on the concentration of the solute particles and remain the independent of their identity. This is the formula of P1x1 P1 naught, where P is the partial pressure of the partial pressure of the component A, x is the mole fraction of the component A, and P1 naught is the partial pressure of the component A, and P1 is the total pressure of the component A, and P1 naught is the partial pressure of the component A. The reduction in this vapor pressure of the solvent P1 is given as, the formula of the P1 is P1 naught minus P1. Okay, if I put the value of P1, the value of P1 is X1 P1 naught. The value of P1 is X1 P1 naught. The formula convert the delta P1 is equal to P1 naught minus P1 X1. If you take the common P1, then the value convert P1 is equal to 1 minus X1. P1 naught 1 minus x1. This is the formula of the delta p1. As x2 is the and the formula and the value of the x2 is the 1 minus x1, the above equation reduced to delta p1 delta p1 is equal to x2 p1. Okay, 1 minus x1 is the value of x2, then we can say delta p1 is equal to p1 naught x2. Okay, now lowering of the vapor pressure of the solution with several non-volatile solute depend upon the sum of the mole fraction of the different solute particles, which is make the above equation as. The formula of the lowering in vapor pressure is, this is the formula, you can see, delta p1 upon p1 is equal to p1 naught minus p1 upon p1 naught, where is equal to x2. x2 is the mole fraction of the component second, or you can say solvent, p1 naught minus p1 upon p1. In this formula, p1 naught minus p1 upon p1 naught, this is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. The terms is that we are doing a study, relative lowering in vapor pressure, the symbol is p1 naught minus p1 upon p1 naught. Okay, and x2 is a mole fraction of the solute. X2 is a mole fraction of the solute. You can easily determine the mole fraction. Formula of mole fraction is equal to mole of component first upon total mole. It means you can say N2 upon n1 plus n2. If the value where n1 and n2 are the number of the moles of solvent and solute respectively present in the solutions. Okay, this is the common thing I told you earlier videos. The above equations can be written as P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught is equal to n1 n2 upon n1 upon n2, because both are the equal. P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught is equal to x2, and the value of the x2 is this. So we can say both the terms are equal. For dilute solution, if you dilute solution, it means if you increase the dilution, if you increase the water, then mole fraction of solute decreases and mole fraction of solvent increases. Then value of n1 increases. So n1 is greater than n2. Then the formula become P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught is equal to n2 upon n1. N2 is the mole fraction of the component. N2 is a mole fraction of solute, and n1 is a mole fraction of the solvent. Then what is the formula of the mole fraction? What is the formula of mole? Formula of the mole is mass per molecular mass. So in this by this equation we get n2 according to n2 w2 upon m2, and then according to n1 is equal to w1 into m1. Okay, w1 upon m1. W is the mass of the solute upon m2 is the molecular mass of solute, and w1 is the mass of the solvent, and m1 is the molecular mass of the solvent. Okay, m1 is the molecular mass of the solvent, and W1, W2 is the mass of the and the molar mass of the solute. Okay, now this is the term number first that we studied. This is very most important terms. You will get the one question from this point in your exams. Second colligator property is elevation of boiling point. Elevation of boiling point. Okay, let's see. Okay. Elevation of boiling point. How the boiling point increases and decreases in this depend upon this point, and we will study this topic regarding in this point. Elevation of boiling point means variations in the boiling point. Increase, I told you earlier, boiling point increases if the any solution contain volatile solute. If the any solution contain no volatile solute, then boiling point decreases. Let's see the theory. Increase in the temperature increase the vapor pressure of a solution. If you increase the temperature, then vapor pressure increases. A liquid boils at temperature where the vapor pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure. What is the boiling point? The boiling point is that when the vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure, that is called boiling point. Vapor pressure of the solvent decreases in the presence of the non-volatile solute. I told you earlier, vapor pressure always decreases on the due to presence of non-volatile solute. If any solvent contain volatile solute, then vapor pressure increases. The boiling point of the solution is always higher than that of the boiling point of the pure solvent which is present in their solution is prepared as. Okay, the boiling point of the solution is always lower than the boiling point of the pure solvent, because every solution contain solute, it may be volatile or non-volatile. Okay, the next point is that the elevation of boiling point also depend on the number of solute molecules rather than their nature. Colligator property. What is the meaning of colligator property? Number of particles means number of solute particle dissolve in the solvent is called colligator property. Means colligator property depend on the number of solute particles dissolved in the solvent. It does not depend upon the nature of particles or nature of solvent or nature of solute. Okay. So the increase in the formula of the elevation of boiling point is delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. Delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. The formula is that delta TB is the elevation in boiling point. This is the elevation in the boiling point is equal to TB minus TB naught. Okay, where TB is the boiling point of the solvent and TB naught is the boiling point of the solution. We can say boiling point of the solvent is always greater than boiling point of the solution. That's why I put TB minus TB naught. Okay. Now, delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught, where TB is the boiling point of the solvent and TB naught is the boiling point of the solution. In dilution solution, the elevation of the boiling point TB is directly proportional to the molal concentration of the solute in a solution. We can say delta TB is directly proportional to molal molality. We can say delta TB. Delta TB is the elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molality. Okay, and you know the formula of molality. If I remove the directly proportional sign, then I will get delta TB is equal to KB. KB is the constant. It is the boiling point constant, elevation in boiling point constant, and molality. Okay, where KB is the elevation in boiling point constant value of elevation of boiling point. Elevation in boiling point constant. Okay, where M is the molality. Okay, what is the molality? Number of solute, if a number of mole of solute dissolve in a gram of solvent, or you can say 1 kg of solvent. Okay, and KB is the elevation in boiling point constant. And what is unit of KB? The unit of KB is kg per mole. Kg per mole. These questions will always ask in your NEET and IIT exams. Okay, kg per mole. Where W2 and M2 is the molar mass. You can see this is the final formula of the elevation in boiling point. This is the final formula. This is the final formula of elevation in boiling point. Okay, delta TB is equal to KB upon m, small is molality. What is the formula of molality? Mass upon molecular mass upon mass of solvent in kg divide by multiply divide by 1000. That's 1000 goes to up. That is the formula of elevation in boiling point. Okay, that will be if by this formula you can find the mass, molecular mass, and elevation in boiling point and elevation in boiling point quotient. Whatever you can find from this formula, this is very most important formula. I want to told you tell you, you will get a question in your board exams from this part. Okay, most important formula. Okay, now move to next slide. Okay, look at the question. Boiling point of the water is 755 mmHg is 99.63 degree centigrade. How much sucrose is to be added in 500 gram of water such that it boils at the 100 degree centigrade? Molal elevation constant for water is 0.52 kilogram kg per mole. Okay, means you get the elevation in boiling point is 0.kg per mole. 0.kg, you can see the unit kilo kg per mole. Means this is the value of elevation in boiling point. Means this is the value of delta TB. Okay, you have to find the mass. You have to find the mass of the solute. Okay, elevation of boiling point is in delta TB is equal to 100 plus 273. Okay, temperature is 100 plus 273, 100 degree centigrade. Okay, convert into the Kelvin. That is the value is, and that is the value of the centigrade. Convert into the Kelvin, you get at 0.37 Kelvin. Mass of the water is 500 gram. Okay, molar mass of the sucrose is 342 gram, and molar elevation constant KB is equal to 0.52. Okay, 0.52 kg per mole. That is the elevation constant. Okay, we know that delta TB is equal to KB 1000 mass upon molecular mass into mass of the solvent in kg. 0.36, if they put the value of KB, what is the value of KB? 0.52. 0.52, that is 0.52. You have to find the mass by the cross multiply. You get this formula. Put the value of delta TB. Delta TB is 0.37. Mass molecular mass is 0.3, 342. W1 mass of solvent in kg 500 upon 1000 into KB. Formula of value of KB is 0.52. Okay, after the calculation, you will get the answer 121.67 gram. Hence, 121.67 gram sucrose is to be added in the solution. Okay, this is the answer. Now move to the next slide. This is the next colligator property is depression of freezing point. Depression of freezing point. This is the another colligator property. What is a freezing point? A temperature at which any compound convert into the liquid. That is called freezing point. At point that will it freeze. Okay, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस इज अ टेम्परेचर एट विच द वेपर प्रेशर और अ सब्सटेंस इज लिक्विड फेज इज इक्वल टू द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस और अ सॉलिड फेज। दिस इज अ सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस इज अ टेम्परेचर एट विच द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस इज वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस ऑफ द लिक्विड फेज इज इक्वल टू द वेपर प्रेशर इन द सॉलिड फेज। पॉइंट नंबर सेकेंड, इफ द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इज इक्वल टू द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द प्योर सॉलिड सॉल्वेंट देन द सॉल्यूशन फ्रीज। ओके, इफ द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ बोथ द फेज विल बिकम इक्वल देन कंपाउंड गोज टू फ्रीज देन सॉल्यूशन फ्रीज। अकॉर्डिंग टू द राउल्ट लॉ, एडिशन ऑफ द नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट डिक्रीज द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट बट इंक्रीज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। ओके, एंड दिस डिक्रीज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट। सो दैट्स वाई वी कैन से सॉल्यूशन डेट कंटेन द नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट इट हैज़ द हाइस्ट फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट बट द प्योर सॉल्वेंट हैज़ द लोएस्ट फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। सो वी कैन से द फॉर्मूला इज डेल्टा टी एफ। डेल्टा टी एफ इज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। इट मे बी टी एफ माइनस टी एफ नॉट। ओके, वी आर टी एफ इज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट सॉरी फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन एंड टी एफ नॉट इज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट। बिकॉज फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन इज हायर देन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट, डेट्स वाई आई पुट द डेल्टा टी एफ, दैट्स वाई आई पुट द टी एफ फॉरवर्ड। ओके, नाउ सी द फॉर्मूला, डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल टू टी एफ माइनस टी एफ नॉट, वेर डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल टू डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, टी एफ इज इक्वल टू फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन एंड टी एफ नॉट इज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट। ओके, नाउ मूव टू नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर द फॉर्मूला आर सेम, द फॉर्मूलाज आर सेम। डेल्टा टी एफ, डेल्टा टी एफ डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू मोलैलिटी। ओके, इफ आई रिमूव द डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल साइन डेट आई देन आई विल गेट डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल टू के एफ मल्टीप्लाई बाय डेल्टा स्मॉल एम, वे के एफ इज इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एम इज द मोलैलिटी। देन नाउ पुट द फॉर्मूला, सिंपल फॉर्मूला, वी कैन से डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल टू के एफ। ओके, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट देन मोलैलिटी। वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला मोलैलिटी? मास अपॉन मॉलिकुलर मास, मास अपॉन मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट देन मास ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट देन मास ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट इन केजी और इन ग्राम। इफ यू टेक द मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट इन ग्राम देन डिवाइड बाय 1000 एंड मल्टीप्लाई बाय द 1000 अपॉन। ओके, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द एलिवेशन इन डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। ओके, नाउ लुक एट द फॉर्मूला, देयर इज अ फॉर्मूला, डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल टू एलिवेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट, मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट डिवाइड बाय 1000। ओके, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला। ओके, डब्ल्यू टू मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट इन ग्राम मल्टीवाइड बाय 1000, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला। नाउ मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला यू हैव टू लर्न इन दिस, बाय दिस फॉर्मूला यू विल गेट अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम इन योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स। ओके, एम टू कैन बी डिटरमाइंड बाय द क्वेश्चन, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला, बाय द फॉर्मूला यू कैन डिटरमाइन द वैल्यू ऑफ के एफ एम टू एंड डब्ल्यू टू एंड एनी थिंग एल्स। ठीक है, बाय दिस फॉर्मूला यू कैन फाइंड फोर टर्म्स, फर्स्ट वन इज डेल्टा टी एफ, फर्स्ट वन इज दिस, बाय दिस फॉर्मूला यू कैन फाइंड डेल्टा टी एफ डिप्रेसिंग फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, सिंपल टी एफ के एफ मीन्स फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट एंड टी एफ मीन्स सॉरी बाय दिस फॉर्मूला यू कैन फाइंड डेल्टा टी एफ मीन्स डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, के एफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट, मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट एंड मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट। दिस टर्म्स यू कैन फाइंड बाय दिस फॉर्मूला। नाउ मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, सॉरी लुक एट द क्वेश्चन, दिस इज द न्यूमेरिकल, कैलकुलेट द मास ऑफ द एक्सोर्बिक एसिड, फॉर्मूला इज C6H10O6 टू बी डिजोल्व इन द 0.75 ऑफ ग्राम ऑफ एसिटिक एसिड टू लोअर इट्स मेल्टिंग पॉइंट बाय द 1.5 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, द वैल्यू ऑफ द के एफ इज 3.9 kg per mole. Always remember the root of the Kf or Kb is kg upon mole. Okay, दिस इज द मास ऑफ द एसिटिक एसिड इज 75 ग्राम, ओके, एंड द मोलर मास इज 176 ग्राम, एंड द टी एफ डेल्टा टी इज इक्वल टू 1.5 केल्विन, देन यू कैन फाइंड द मास ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट इन केजी, ओके, मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट, ओके. द फॉर्मूला इज डेट डेल्टा टी बी, वैल्यू ऑफ डेल्टा टी बी इज 1.5, मॉलिक्यूलर मास 176, मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट 75 अपॉन 1000, देन के बी इज इक्वल टू 1000, द वैल्यू ऑफ द के बी इज 3.9, यू विल गेट द 5.08 अप्रॉक्सीमेट, हैंज 5.08 ग्राम ऑफ एब्जॉर्बिक एसिड इज नीड टू बी डिजॉल्व, ओके. दिस इज द आंसर द बाई विच द बाय द फॉर्मूला यू कैन डिटरमाइन द मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट एंड यू कैन डिटरमाइन द एलिवेशन इन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, ओके. नाउ द नेक्स्ट कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी इज ऑस्मोसिस एंड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. आई थिंक यू नो द वॉट इज द ऑस्मोसिस, ट्रांसफर ऑफ द सॉल्यूट फ्रॉम द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन टू लो कंसेंट्रेशन इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोसिस. यू कैन से ट्रांसफर ऑफ द एनी सॉलिड पार्टिकल एंड एनी पार्टिकल फ्रॉम द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन टू लो कंसेंट्रेशन इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोसिस. एंड वॉट इज द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर, वेन ट्रांसफर ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स फ्रॉम द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन टू लो कंसेंट्रेशन इट क्रिएट अ प्रेशर ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वॉल, दैट इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर, ओके. लेट अस सी सम थ्योरी. वी हैव ऑफ्टन ऑब्जर्व दैट रो मैंगोज श्रिंक वेन केप्ट इन द सॉल्ट वाटर, दैट इज कॉल्ड ब्रिन सोल्यूशन. फ्लावर्स रिमेन फ्रेश फॉर द लॉन्गर टाइम when kept in the water. Why it is happening? Because it's transfer the particles from the high concentration to low concentration. This is due to the fact that the small solvent molecules such as the water and capable of the passing through the pores present in every cell. These pores allow the small solvent like water to pass through the but hinders the passing of the large molecules. This membrane passing such pore is known as the semi-permeable membrane. By the semi-permeable membrane, small particles can be passed, but the large particle cannot be passed. Okay, the process of flow of the solvent from the pure solvent to the solution. The process of the flow of the solvent from the pure solvent to the solution through a semi-permeable membrane is termed as the osmosis. What is the meaning of osmosis? Transfer of the solvent from solvent to solution. This flow of the solvent to the solution continue until the stage of the equilibrium is reached. Okay, transfer of the solvent from the pure solvent to the solution is continue until equilibrium is reached. Application of the extra pressure on the solution can be terminate the flow of the solvent from the pure solvent to the solution. This pressure is called osmotic pressure. Okay, when the pressure is arise on the surface of the wall, that is called osmotic pressure of the solution. It is a colligative property that depend upon the concentration of the solution, and it is basically meant to stop the passes of the solvent molecule through a semi-permeable membrane into the solution. Solvent molecules generally flow from the lower concentration to higher concentration. This flow of the solvent from the dilute solution to be concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane is due to the phenomena of the osmosis. Means solvent molecules generally flow from the low concentration to high concentration. This is called osmosis. This flow of the solvent from the dilute solution to the concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. Okay, look at this picture. This is a pectoral diagram. In this diagram, you can say this is a semi-permeable membrane. This is salt water. Okay, this is the fresh water. Fresh water, that is called pure water. You can say water is flowing from the fresh water to solution because this part contain the high concentration of solvent and shifted to the this part because this part contain the high concentration of the solvent and shifted to the this part that contain the low concentration of the solvent. Okay, this is called the osmosis, and it generate a pressure on the wall that is called osmosis pressure. When the equal number of the particles are present in both the side, then you can say equilibrium is reached. Okay, that is called the osmosis, and you can say osmotic pressure. What is the formula of the osmotic pressure? You can see this is the formula. Pi is equal to CRT. Okay, I got to explain you. Wait, look at carefully. You can say ideal gas equation is equal to PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to nRT, where P is the pressure, V is the volume, and N is the number of mole, R is the gas constant, and T is the temperature. Okay, P means pressure, and you are finding the osmotic pressure. Then send the V at the dead side, and you will get P is equal to N R T upon V. What is the meaning of N is mass upon molecular mass, because this is a mole. Then formula become P is equal to mass upon molecular mass into V into R T. Okay, this term is called C, concentration. This term is called concentration. Then P is equal to CRT. Okay, P is equal to CRT. So the final formula is P is equal to CRT, or you can say P, you can say pi. Pi is the osmotic pressure, then pi is equal to CRT. Okay, this is the formula of the osmotic pressure. Pi is equal to CRT. C means concentration, R means gas constant, and T is the temperature, and pi is the osmotic pressure. Okay, now you can solve the noted down this formula. This is very most important. You can solve the questions by this formula. Now see the questions. Calculation of the osmotic pressure means pi in the Pascal exerted by a solution prepared by dissolving 1 gram of the polymer of molar mass 185,000 in 450 ml of water at 30 degrees centigrade. First, what is the formula? NRT, you can say, and NRT upon V. Volume of the water is 450 ml. Okay, temperature is 31010. Basically, temperature is given 37 degrees centigrade. You have always taken the temperature in the Kelvin, because Kelvin is the standard value. Okay, the temperature is 310. Number of the moles of polymer is N, is equal to mass upon molecular mass. Mass is the 1 gram. Mole, what is the mole of the polymer? Mass upon molecular mass. Mass is 1, and molecular mass is the 18500. Okay, then find the osmotic pressure. Pi is equal to N upon VRT. What is the value of N? Is 1 upon 8 for this is this. And what is the value of V? What is the value of R? Value of R is 0.8314 10 to the power 3. And what is the value of T? The value of T is 310. And the what is the value of volume is 0.5 liter. Then you can, the answer is 31 Pascal. Okay, this is the answer of 31 Pascal. Now shift to the next slide. The calculation of the molar mass from the osmotic pressure. How you can determine the mass or molar mass? I told you earlier, the formula is simple. The formula is pi is equal to CRT, R is the gas constant, pi is the osmotic pressure, pi is equal to N2 upon VRT, V is the volume of the solution, N2 is the mole of solute, W is the mass of solute, and M2 is the molecular mass of solute, and now is equal to N2. N2 is equal to M W2 upon M2. Okay, this is the formula. Okay, this is the formula. Pi is equal to W2 upon V. W2 upon M2 is equal to V multiplied by RT. Okay, if you want to find the W2, then for W2, then cross multiply is that. If you find the M2, then cross multiply is that W2 into RT upon V. Okay, this is the formula by you can find the molecular mass. Now move to the next slide. On the basis of the, now we are going to study about the classification of the solution on the basis of osmotic pressure. Classification of the solution on the basis of osmosis. There are three types of the solution: isotonic solution, hypertonic solution, and hypertonic solution. There are three types of solution: isotonic solution, hypertonic solution, and hypertonic solution. What is the meaning of isotonic solution? Two solutions posing the same osmotic pressure at a given temperature as termed as isotonic solution. Okay, hypertonic solution, in the event that the medium of has a lower conjugation कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ वाटर देन द सेल, इम्प्लाइंग दैट इज इट्स अ कंसेंट्रेटेड सोल्यूशन. द सेल विल लूज द वाटर बाय द ऑस्मोसिस. सच ए सोल्यूशन इज नोन एज द हाइपरटोनिक सोल्यूशंस. ओके, हाइपरटोनिक सोल्यूशन इन द इवेंट दैट द मीडियम एनकम्पेसिंग द सेल हैज अ हायर वाटर कंसेंट्रेशन देन द सेल. ओके, इट इज कॉल्ड द हाइपरटोनिक सोल्यूशन. ओके, द नेक्स्ट एंड द लास्ट टर्म इज, सॉरी, द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. यू स्टडीड ऑस्मोसिस, रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस दैट इज कॉल्ड आर ओ. द टर्म यू हैव लिसन, आई थिंक यू टर्म दिस लिसन इन द योर वाटर प्यूरिफायर. आर ओ मीन्स रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. यू सी आर ओ, यू वी एंड द टी डी एस, दिस बेसिक टर्म्स यूज इन द वाटर प्यूरिफायर. ओके, तो आर ओ मीन्स रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. टूडे आई विल टोल्ड यू वॉट इज रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस, देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस एंड यू कैन, दिस नॉलेज यू कैन अप्लाइंग एट योर होम. रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस, एज द नेम सजेस्टेड, रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस इज जस्ट द रिवर्स, इज जस्ट द रिवर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ द ऑस्मोसिस. इट इज द रिवर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस. इन द ऑस्मोसिस यू स्टडीड ट्रांसफर ऑफ द सोलवेंट फ्रॉम द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन टू सोल्यूशन ऑफ द. ओके, ऑस्मोसिस कैन अकर नेचुरली वेन एवर देर इज डिफरेंस इन द कंसेंट्रेशन बिटवीन द टू सोल्यूशन, बट रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस टेक प्लेस ओनली वेन द एक्सटर्नल सोल्यूशन, एक्सटर्नल एनर्जी इज अप्लाइड टू द मोर सलाइन सोल्यूशन. ओके, लिसन इन द बेसिक लैंग्वेज, वॉट इज ऑस्मोसिस? ट्रांसफर ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट, ट्रांसफर ऑफ सॉल्वेंट फ्रॉम द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन टू लो कंसेंट्रेशन मीन्स ट्रांसफर ऑफ द प्योर सॉल्वेंट इन टू द सोल्यूशन इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोसिस. बट ट्रांसफर ऑफ द सोल्यूशन दैट कंटेन द सोल्यूट पार्टिकल इन टू द सॉल्वेंट इज कॉल्ड रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. ओके, बट द ट्रांसफर ऑफ द सोल्यूशन इन टू द सॉल्वेंट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, इट रिक्वायर्ड द एक्सटर्नल एनर्जी सोर्स, दैट सोर्स इज कॉल्ड द रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस दैट इज यूज इन योर वाटर प्योरीफायर. ओके, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द लार्ज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर टू बी सोल्यूशन, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द लार्ज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर टू बी सोल्यूशन साइड रिवर्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द ऑस्मोसिस. दिस फिनोमेना मेक द प्योर सॉल्वेंट फ्लो आउट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन थ्रू द सेमी परमीबल मेम्ब्रेन. रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस इज एसेंशियली यूज इन योर डिस्टिलेशन ऑफ सी वाटर. यू कैन सी दिस इज द प्योर वाटर, फ्रेश वाटर, दिस इज योर सलाइन वाटर एंड दिस इज रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस अकर. प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड ऑन द, प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड ऑन द सोल्यूशन, दैट्स वाई सोल्यूशन गोज टू द सॉल्वेंट. ओके, यू कैन सी वाटर फ्लो फ्रॉम द सोल्यूशन टू सॉल्वेंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस एंड रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस ऑलवेज नीड्स अ हाई प्रेशर और हाई एनर्जी. ओके, वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस? जस्ट सडनली आई टोल्ड यू रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस इज यूज फॉर द प्योरिफिकेशन ऑफ वाटर एंड इट इज, दैट्स वाई एंड इट इज ऑल्सो यूज इन द योर वाटर प्योरीफायर एंड दिस इज नीड्स वेरी हाई अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी एंड हाई अमाउंट ऑफ मनी. देन यूज ऑफ द रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस इन द वाटर प्योरीफिकेशन इज दैट रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस इज एक्सटेंसिवली यूज इन द डिस्टिलेशन ऑफ सी वाटर. ओके, डिस्टिलेशन ऑफ सी वाटर, अ पोरस फिल्म ऑफ द सेलुलोज एसिटेट इज यूज एज ए मेम्ब्रेन विच इज परमेबल वाटर. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क मी सर वॉट इज अ सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन, द मेम्ब्रेन विच हैज़ द पोर साइज इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन द 100 नैनोमीटर. ओके, द पोर साइज इज नॉट लार्जर और नॉट स्मॉलर, नॉट टू मच लार्जर, नॉट टू मच स्मॉलर, दैट इज कॉल्ड द सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, द मेम्ब्रेन इज द परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन इज हैज़ द लार्जेस्ट पोर साइज एंड द नॉन परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन हैज़ द वेरी स्मॉल पोर साइज, बट द सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन हैज़ द मीडियम पोर साइज. ओके, फॉर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द वी कैन यूज द सेलुलोज लेयर डिप्ड इन द एसिडेट सोल्यूशन. ओके, प्रेशर लार्जर देन द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड ऑन द सी वाटर सोल्यूशन विच अलाउ द पासिंग आउट ऑफ प्योर वाटर होल्डिंग द बैक एंड बल्क ऑफ कंटामिनेटेड थ्रू द मेम्ब्रेन मेड ऑफ द पॉलीमर. द मेजर ऑफ द प्रेशर रिक्वायर्ड रिलीज अपॉन द सॉल्ट ग्रुपिंग ऑफ द फूड वाटर. Greater concentration of feed water require the more pressure. If the solution contain the high concentration, then it require the more pressure. Okay, as the water enter the RO membrane, the under the great pressure, the water molecule pass through the semi-permeable membrane. The membrane is permeable, is impermeable to salt and the water contaminate. Hence, it is not allowed to pass through it. So the water, so the salt particles and the another contaminated particles are not transfer. So that's why we use the semi-permeable membrane. Okay, you can see the leftover contaminated water is then discharged through the rejected stream, and finally we can get the drained out is feedback into the feed water supply. This water will again undergo the same procedure and will be purified in the same way. That is a feed water. Okay, pass through the RO membrane. That is a RO membrane. Reject the stream, higher concentration than the feed water. Then we get the permeate water. That is the low concentration of salt. This water contain the low concentration of salt. Okay, now we have finished this chapter, and I think this is the most important chapter regarding to in your board exam. The questions from this chapter will come in your RBC and CBC exam. So read this chapter with easiest way, and if you don't understand the topics, you can revise this video again and again and see carefully. And I would like to told you the personally, you have to solve the so many numericals on this question, on this chapter. You can took your RBC books, CBC books, and any NCERT books that contain this chapter. And all the NCERT books of class 12 science chemistry contain this chapter. You can solve this, or you have a I would like to suggest to a book is MTJ publication book, MTJ publication books contain the this books is good for the 11th, 12th and NEET and IIT exam. This book contain the so many examples and so many questions. This is the MTJ fingertips. The book name is MTJ fingertip of chemistry, biology, physics. Okay, so you can purchase the MTJ fingertips for the chemistry. Or this book this is very most important book for your chemistry preparation of the 11th, 12th and the NEET exams. Okay, we have completed this chapter. Read the see the video again and again, and complete your chapter. Okay, now do the some question of regarding this video. Question number first, what is the reverse osmosis and explain their function. Question number second, calculate the mass of the sugar to be dissolved in 150 gram of the ethanol to lower its melting point by 1.5 degree centigrade, and the value of the Kf is 3.9 kilogram per mole. Question number third, boiling point of the wine at 750 mm Hg is 60 degree centigrade. How much salt is to be added to 800 gram of water, much such that it boil at 100 degree centigrade. Molar elevation constant of the water is 0.52 kilogram per mole. Question number four, explain the process of the osmotic pressure. Okay, yeah, I think we have finished this chapter and all the topics I have done in this chapter. Then now tomorrow we will do the another chapter of the class 12 chemistry. Let's see which chapter we will do. Okay, and thank you so much for watching this video. Bye bye.